All right, you're looking at my point of view at the Palms Room at the Crown Casino, Melbourne. And this is Josh Owen.
Oh, I don't know.
Josh Owen playing with James Reyne. Johnny Watson up the back there.
All right.
Hello there.
Hello. Hello, fellas.
Hello.
And Josh is going to give us a rig rundown.
A rig rundown. I'll have to do one day.
Josh Owen. Because John Bollinger, I'm after your job, fella. This is Josh Owen.
Hello.
You'll be next if you want to hang around.
Yeah,
I'll do a rig rundown. Okay. So, what do you got there, Josh? A Relic Stratocaster?
Well, this is my first ever Strat that I bought straight out of high school. Saved for a year to buy it.
Straight out of school?
Straight out of school.
Yeah. What year was that?
So that was 1998.
So this is a 98 American.
No, this is an 83 57 reissue. Wow. That I've played forever.
Yeah. Japanese or American?
American.
Yeah.
And the only mod to it is that the pickups in it are wound by Dwight Wood. In Brizzy.
DRW guitars.
DRW guitars, Blue Rock pickup. So
Blue Rock pickups.
He's gone with a sort of a Texas special,
yeah,
but with more air in it. You know, so not too much mid. They're not mid rangey. They're still airy and can't really hear that on the phone, obviously. But
well, they'll get the idea.
So they're not too hot. Nice clarity. And then of course the other two guitars.
This
blue fella is actually James Reyne's blue pale Telecaster. It's like a thin line.
Yeah.
With Porter pickups, I believe.
Yeah, that'd be right. Yeah. Hello, Brian and John.
And it's an excellent guitar. Yeah. And
it's cute, isn't it?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Baby
and
blue.
Light as a feather.
Because it's got nothing in it. It's thin line kind of.
Yep.
No, it's F-hole.
And
this wonderful looking gold Les Paul here.
And that's my 73 Deluxe.
Yeah.
That I refretted with stainless, and that's the only mod.
Oh, you put stainless steel frets on it.
Stainless steel frets, so it plays like an absolute beast, and it's an amazing sounding guitar, and I love it.
And has the headstock on it broken yet?
Yes, it has been broken before.
Okay, well that's the main thing, isn't it?
So it's a real one. And of course, this is all the relicking has happened from years and years of playing this thing. So
naturally relics.
Naturally relics. This is not the only thing I did do was I did sand the neck down and put true oil or gun oil, that is to say, on the back because it was getting sticky in humid situations. So that's the only real difference.
Okay.
With the guitar.
You don't often see a properly relic guitar that's
no,
been
that's
played
right.
in, do you? It's quite unusual.
Yeah, and I need to refret it. It's a bit.
Are you going to put stainless on that as well?
I will. That's
okay.
Next. So,
and what do you plug these fine weapons into?
So the weapon is going into the AX8.
The Fractal Audio AX8.
And the reason for that is that it's consistent for our esteemed sound man out the front, Mr. Tosh.
Where is he?
Or Grant Walsh, as his real name, but we call him Tosh.
He's there, I think he's having a week.
But yeah, consistent for front of house in stereo wedges.
Yep, so coming back at you through two Nexo wedges.
Nexo wedges.
You used to use IEMs, didn't you?
Well, I did sometimes when we needed to, so and I have many times.
When you've got a couple of thousand watts coming back at you with an Nexo,
it's quite impressive.
Them,
it's very impressive. It's good stuff.
Okay, give us a little. I know the phone's going to compress it and it's going to sound crap, but go on.
So all it is, basically, I've got a Vibrato King or Vibro King.
Yeah.
Model. And model, and that's kind of roaring.
Yeah.
So that's how it goes.
It's pretty lovely.
It's lovely. And it's kind of on the edge of breaking up.
Yes.
And then I've got basically...
You had to ask him, didn't you?
Yeah.
You had to ask him.
You'll be next. You're next.
Chris has packed my stuff up. I can't wait. Might only 5 minutes. Sorry, Josh.
Oh. James has to do this, Chris.
He's trying to get this.
Sorry. Sorry, back.
And then it's basically gain stages. So it's like a micro boost.
Yep.
And then second micro boost with a bit more.
More boost.
And then
more
more. Esoteric, really clean boost. So it's a bit more.
Wow. And how many boosts are there?
It's like three boosts.
Three levels of
three more. Levels of boost.
Three levels of more.
Pushing the amp, and then an 808.
And an 808 as well.
And that's what gives it the singing.
The mid
stuff. The mid range.
The haunting.
And
the haunting mid.
The solo tone.
Okay.
Know? And then
play a solo for us.
And then
give us the intro to. Oh no.
All right. Oh no, not you again.
Yes.
All right. So, oh no, not you again. It's a second from the back, of course.
Yeah. Can you give us a tab as well?
Some delays and reverbs, and that's all you need. And
that's all you
delays
need.
And reverbs and overdrive.
And you can just pop that in a little briefcase and off,
and
you,
off
go.
You go.
What are you doing with the mission pedal?
And that's my so on the Les Paul, I find it a little bit more difficult to reach the volume knobs for volume swells, which I do very easily on here. But
do you use your pinky to do those swells?
I do, but
technical question.
I find it a little bit more difficult on the Les Paul, so I use the old.
The volume pedal.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
Okay.
And that's about it.
What sort of beer do you drink?
I like a good, strong, thick ale, like an IPA, but very hoppy, you know.
Lovely choice.
Meaty beer.
Yes.
What kind of scotch do you like?
Well,
you
a little bit of brand placement.
That's right. Yeah, hot scotch. Yeah, what kind of scotch do you like?
Quite keen on rum, too, I think, aren't you?
I'm very keen on rum. Benaharben is the one I'm liking in terms of scotch.
Okay, well, we'll take that.
Benaharben
well.
Scotch is Irish.
No, it's a scotch. It's a scotch.
Scotch.
Scotch
whiskey.
We like whiskey, good whiskey.
That's great.
A gentleman's stone.
Yeah, it's a gentleman's stone.
Well, thanks for being with us today, Josh.
No worries.
And we'll see you on stage, huh?
No worries. See you soon.
Okay.